Hello guys, thank you all for watching a new episode of DIYRC. In today's episode we have a new field charger from Toolkitrc, the M6. It's one of the smallest, lightest and good functional, multifunctional LiPo charger. Well, it charges also several different other batteries that I have seen. It's very nice, very light, very compact. It fits in your pocket. It got a big fan, so it cools really good. It worked really simple and it got some extra functions to measure your receiver's signals and test if it's got a fault in it. So you can do a lot of things out in the field. It makes it very handy and you are able to charge 1 to 6 cell LiPo batteries. And to charge them you need to have an input of 7 volts minimum to 28 volts. So that's a 2 cell to an 8 cell. I'll be using my favorite 16,000 mAh 4 cell battery that I even sometimes use to jumpstart my car. So that's a very handful battery, can be used very many times. And just XC60 connector to connect it. And you get a nice screen. Forgive me for the motor rider, they are driving me nuts whole day. On the other side you can connect the battery. Oh my god, it's really pumping. But yeah, they are having fun, it's summer. But yeah, it's not fun if you hear it all day in and out. That's where you can connect the battery, on the right side. On the left side you even have an USB connector so you can charge up your phone, whatever. And the 3 pins is for your receiver. I'm going to test that later. Just first show you the charger options. Then we got charger. I'm going to choose the arrow to go through the menu. And then we pick, let's go into settings. The lower input is 10 volts. The input power can be 150 watts. There's a safety temperature of 70 degrees and a safety time of 120 minutes. There's some kind of a discharge mode internally. We got an idle beep for 5 minutes. And I can change the SBUS values. Then the backlight, buzzers, sound. I got a HD port, language, and default. So let's go back. And we can go to output where we can test the power, SBUS, PPM, PPM. We can also go and measure. And this is the battery resistance. Now it shows the voltage, the overall voltage, the temperature is 39 degrees. Then we can also balance it. Here we got the internal resistance mode. Let's go back. You can also test the SBUS, the PPM and the PPM, but we're going to show that later on. Let's go back and go to charging and see all the functions that we have. We can choose upstairs for LiPo battery. We can also set for a new one. We have 2 memories that you can set for, like if you have 2 batteries, 1000 mAh and the other is 1500 mAh, or 3 cell, 4 cell, then you can set them to make it just easier, though you have to connect and start charging and recognize everything itself. But I always like to set things manual. We go into new battery. So at the top we have battery type that we can change from LiPo to all the 5 other ones that it charges, but we need LiPo mainly. And we can set the end voltage. Cells will be automatically recognized, so this knows that it's a 3 cell battery. Then we can set up the charge current for balanced charge or fast medium charge or super fast charge. 2 amps is for balanced charge, you can set it to 5 amps of medium charge, you can always set it all the way up to 10 amps. That is a super fast charge, and maybe takes only 15 minutes to charge a 1000 mAh battery, maybe even less. But this battery is already full, so I need to discharge it or set it into storage mode. And that's what we can do down below here. We have the discharge current, so you can even discharge it really fast. And then down below we have charge, discharge and storage mode. Click it. All the information clocked. It's correct. It discharges to 3.8 volts. That is perfect. Press OK. And it starts, but you need to make sure that the main battery and the balance lead is connected. But that's going to take a long time, so let's skip forward and test all the other extra functions, because if it discharges, it charges, believe me, it works. It's a bit of fiddly. It was a little bit of a fiddly job to get the servo connector in, because it's all brand new. But you can hear it click. Just do it off camera. Turn it on again. Got the measure device. PPM, that's what it's on. Turn on the radio. Alright, you can see that they are having all the functions. I can check the number. I go to 1000 up to a little bit over 2000. And this way you can see if there are any issues with your receiver signal down at the field. Perfectly working. Nice, but many times we're gonna be soldering that directly to the flight controller and not really having a servo connector. So how many times I'm gonna be using it down in the field, I'm not really 100% sure. But it's nice to have it, just in case. And it works. It's not like it's a fake function or something. It really works. Give my thumbs up. You can find the links down below. I really hope you like this video and take a minute to subscribe. And I'm gonna say thank you all for watching and I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.